mean to do that.
But I can't get close enough to you. There you are. Lean a little more. Ten is up. Let me get the snap.
And 17, if you guys are interested, your shadows will be 8 feet long tonight.
How many meters is that, Bob?
I'll draw it out. I'll step it out for you. You can measure it.
Well, I don't know. Should I take my gloves off? Need my cover gloves?
Why don't you leave mine for a while, see where we're going. See what the boulder field looks like up there.
Well, I know what it's going to look like.
Now you don't.
The point is, my hands will be much better off without them.
Take them off, then.
Well.
Okay, battery covers are closed in tight. High gain is already oriented. Oh, they've even got TV, I guess.
That's a firm.
But fruit.
And Tina, when you push the rover circuit breakers, then how about giving us a battery temperature reading on the rover bath?
Tell them what my batteries are reading if I can.
Well, let's see if I can do something else. I'm waiting.
No, I'm done, Jack.
They're flattened. All of them are flattened. There's a strong foliation of vesicles in the rock. Most of them are flattened, and they are up to 15 or 20 centimeters in diameter and about 5 to 6 centimeters thick or wide.
Outstanding.
And there's some beautiful north overhangs all around the block. Well, on the north side of the block.
Okay, that's the best place to have north overhang, and I guess that means one of you guys might grab the SEC, the small can, before you leave the rover.
Okay, Bob, it's going to take me a while to dust, I'll tell you.
Okay.
Hard to get around here.
Roger
Bob,
on that.
Now let's get it straight. You want the north overhang sample in the SEC, or the short can?
Miracle of miracles, they don't want the short can. I'm not sure I understand that, Jack, but they don't want the short can here, they say. I guess they're looking for volcanics today. They're looking for volcanics today, Jack.
Oh, they are, huh? We
found
those yesterday.
Well, they're hoping again at Station 9.
This is, now, that foliation I mentioned does not go all the way through the rock. There are variations in texture. One zone was strongly foliated. There's another. It almost looks like a large inclusion of non-vesicular rock within the vesicular rock. There may be some auto brecciation involved in the formation of this thing. It really looks mineralogically like the light-colored samples from the South Massif. But I tell you, that's only because it's light-colored, and I can't give you any more than that right now until we get a fresh surface.
110 degrees on a step, and you want the tape, the cover closed, right?
Cover open, please. Cover open, both off.
Okay. Cover's open.
Okay, and did you get the batteries?
Oh, my golly.
LRV battery cover's open. We didn't copy that, Gene.
No, I didn't copy that you wanted them open. I just got 107. I was about to ask you that.
Okay, we'd like them open. And, Jack, while I'm interrupting everybody here, how about a frame count, if convenient?
That's Jack Schmitt at the Rock.
Oh, shoot, Bob, I gave you one at the Rock. It's now 6-8.
Okay, copy that.
Dude, I never...
You can't believe how tough it is getting around this river on this slope.
I think I'll,
I think we're probably pitch 20 and roll 20.
I think I'll get over here and get a pan while we're waiting to sample. Oh, I gotta dust those radiators. I can't leave them like that. I tell you, this is not a very good place to dust them, though. Let me try one time. Oh, boy. Be careful, Gino. Need some help?
Help? I need a little finesse, though.
Right. Now, that's a hard rock.
Yeah,
that's a hard rock.
You might be able to do it, I can't.
I can't get down there. Okay. We need some of the soil outside the shadow here.
How about over where your bag went?
Let's move around here to... I think there's some... Oops.
Get on this slope over here.
Okay. How about out over in here? Are we supposed to get a... Where are we here? I don't know. I'd like to get... Now, when you face uphill, your camera faces down.
We want to get a rake on the rim of that little crater down there, I guess.
Okay, and, 17, Roger. You were asking about objectives. Of course, the primary objective is documented samples of the blocks. And then also we'd like to get some of the a rake and soil sample out in the surface, namely the rim crater there, if that's available. And one of the things, of course, we're looking for is a variety of rocks here. If there's more than just the one boulder, you can sample the boulder for a while, but we'd be interested in seeing if there's more than just the single type of rock. Probably also samples from both sides,
okay.
Both halves of the rock. What we said this morning in terms of combining stations 6 and 7 to an hour and 20 minutes.
Come on up here, Gino. Okay, you can.
And so it's sort of your option as to how much time you spend here and how much you go on to Station 7 and spend. If you feel it's worthwhile, we could spend essentially all that hour and 20 minutes at this station. But if we did that, we'd like to get a fair variety of blocks
okay.
if they're available.
Okay. Gino, we can sample some of the light colored green. Matter of fact, this block looks different.
So does that
gray
one. That's why I've been photographing it.
What it is, I think...
It's a blue-gray.
It's a big blue-gray rock. Itself is crystalline, I believe. The inclusions are much more sharply defined, and it's non-vesicular, and it's included, or at least it's in contact with, the very vesicular anorthocytic gabbro. Right up there. See
yeah.
that?
Yeah, the whole big one. I just...
Did you get some pictures of it?
I bounced around here, I took pictures of it.
Look, we can get some of that light-colored stuff in there along with the blue-gray.
Try to get as big a piece of that inclusion as we can. There's...
You see it up in there?
Yep. I think we're out of line of sight with them. We're behind
yeah.
a boulder.
Sorry about that, but...
Now, we can hear you loud and clear. We're just looking at rocks right now.
You can see where we've been pounding on this rock. We didn't succeed in getting samples everywhere. And I'm giving you a 90-degree corner.
Bob, it looks to me like there are inclusions of blue-gray in the gabbro, in the anorthocytic gabbro.
Positively outstanding.
But you're saying you think this whole big blue-gray thing is an inclusion?
Yes, sir. And there's some little ones over here.
Yeah, but then within the blue-gray, we've got all these other fragments.
Well, that's right. It's just several generations of activity. It looks like the gabbro, though, picked up the fragmental breccia as inclusions. Bob, I really look that way right now. There's a...
OK, Okay, Charlie's here mumbling something about it looking just like house rock.
It's very crystalline, I'll tell you. It's not a breccia, not like house rock. Not to take anything away from house rock, though. Hey, Bob, there's a lot of manling on a very shallow slope of a fracture here on one of the upslope blocks. I would assume it's just part of the talus picked up as it rolled down, but if it's worth sampling, you might think about.
Okay, Dean, if you can get that fairly readily, why don't you, you can perhaps just scoop it up with the bag.
That's exactly what I can do.
If you can get up to the rock, that
and,
is.
And it'll be in my flight line stereo, and it's going to be bag 557, and I'll take an after and show you where it came from.
Okay, copy that.
It's the easiest part of the rock in the world to work. Man, here's a big white class. There's one on top about a foot and a half across, and here's one must be 2 feet across, 3 feet. And that's in the blue-gray. You're like a kid playing in a sandbox. I got a set of the outcrop from which the boulder came. They're moved a little bit. I can't. That's it. I got a few pictures looking up the boulder track and then off to the right, to the left a little bit. And one off to the right. I think, I'm not sure how well they overlap. That's just an awful hard shot.
Okay, good on that. And if you're done with that, you got a frame count, are you still taking them, I guess it looks like.
Yeah. Okay, my camera's playing the magazine Foxtrot. Is on about frame two when I cycled through it, and I've got the coral set, and I'm going to go get it. And I didn't hear where you said to put it, Bob.
Anywhere.
Oh man, you're easy.
And did you get
anywhere,
your
not
did
the
get
bottom
your...
of a small crater, huh?
Any place. And did you get your camera dusted?
Yeah. I got it all dusted in a mag exchange.
Good.
It's core 48.
Copy that.
Okay. I'll even get you a picture of it.